Yo, what's up guys? Gamer Jake here. Welcome back to another video. I may sound a little awkward in this because I haven't done a video for a while, so just please bear with me. Today, we will be talking about not only my favorite horror movie, but the greatest horror movie in history, and that is Kill Baby Kill, released in 1966 and directed by Mario Bava. Okay, so before I get into this, YouTube may have a problem with what I do and say in this video because of the title itself and the way I'm gonna explain it. If YouTube has a problem with it, I may as well just delete the video, but hopefully there's nothing wrong with it. Anyways, the story of this movie is this village is haunted by a little girl who is a ghost, and the little girl goes around and tempts adults to kill themselves basically. And now after I say that, YouTube is probably gonna have me take this video down, hopefully not. But everything about this movie is so interesting, interesting moments like this. And yeah, this movie, if you have kids or if you're gonna or if you're like if you How do I describe this, or how do I say this? If your kids want to watch a horror film, I would recommend letting them watch this because this movie is PG. So yeah, this horror movie is actually appropriate for kids. Like, it's not a kid movie, but I mean, if your kids want to watch a horror film, then I would definitely recommend letting your kids watch this. Anyways, let me just show you guys the trailer because the trailer can explain how the movie is. I feel like the trailer explains the movie better than I do, so just watch it.
Resway, the facts you're looking for can only be found at Billigram's. I'm sure the inspector's here.
Get out of my sight, or you'll be sorry.
It's like running headlong into a wall of silence. They're suspicious, distrustful, and the way they react to my questions.
Stop! Melissa.
Another one. Herr Karl. Why did you disobey my orders?
I'm scared, Inspector. I have a certain feeling that they'll murder us.
So yeah, that technically explained the movie better than I did. I just wanted to go over some of the moments in this movie really fast. So like this movie had some not only good scares, but It had a thing where this movie had a big thing for like zoom-ins, like where the camera like zoomed in really hard on something. And yeah, like so there's two scares that I want to show you guys, and then two just not unique moments. So yeah, here's one of the scares. Like, look at that. Like, hold on. I mean, this, to be honest, this zoom-in part actually kind of got me. Like, I did not expect this to happen. Like, and not only that, but this one was like the jump scare of the movie. It wasn't really a jump scare, but this scare was like the biggest one in the movie, in my opinion. So yeah, like as I watched this for the first time, like I knew there was going to be like some type of scare that was going to happen right there, 'cause like the music just started rising, and I mean it kind of made you expect that something was going to happen, but I did not expect like this. I did not expect like that to happen. Yeah, like I mean yeah, that's what I mean. Like, I mean, you kind of expect something's gonna happen right there, but you don't expect something like that to happen. Like, seriously. And these aren't scares or anything. These are just really interesting moments that I just wanted to talk about really fast. Starting with this one.
Hello. Tell me, what's your name?
I'm just gonna stop it right there. Yeah, you get the idea of that. Like, this was probably one of my favorite scenes in this movie because, like, everything about this scene was just really interesting. Like, it's like something I've never seen before, is what I mean. Like, just everything, yeah, like, I don't wanna repeat myself, but I really love this scene, and, like, they just did it in a really interesting way. Like, you know what I mean. Anyways, one last scene I wanted to go over. This scene was also pretty unique. So yeah, like this scene right here was also pretty interesting. When I saw this part for the first time, I was thinking like, dude, what is this? Like, I was just con at first I was confused on why they kept like zooming in, zooming out at that part. I mean, at first I was confused, but then I'm like, no, wait, what am I saying? So I ended up realizing that this scene right here, it was really interesting how they did it, like the zooming in, zooming out. It was actually supposed to show that okay, from that other scene, her na the ghost girl is named Melissa. Melissa is swinging on a swing in the cemetery, and that was just showing that zooming in, zooming out, that was showing that she was like, swinging. I mean, it's hard to explain, but it was really interesting how they made this scene. Like, I never, th like, other movie directors don't really think about doing stuff like that. Just saying. Well, anyways, guys, that's all I have to say about this movie. Kill Baby Kill, one of the greatest horror films I've ever seen. I definitely recommend checking this movie out. It's PG, and it is appropriate. It is appropriate for young viewers. So yeah, I mean, you can even show your kids this movie. They would just have to be at a little older, like 10. They would have to. In my opinion, if you were to show your kids this movie, your kid would have to be at least 7 or older. That's my opinion. But yeah, great movie for the family, great movie for yourself. Like, I recommend checking this out. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe, and hopefully I don't get copyright for any of those videos I showed, and hopefully YouTube does not have a problem with this video for everything I talked about and everything. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video. See you later.